Hello everyone, Luis here. Today I will review a high precision resin called M70 from a brand called Resin. I will show you some prints and some feature of this resin, and also I will share my settings and with you guys so if you can try it at home, okay? Try new resins is something that I really love, and this is the first video of a series of resin reviews that I will post on this channel regularly from now on. And I will share my discovery with you and help you to decide if some resins are worth buying or not, okay? So stay tuned and subscribe to be notified every time I post a new video. And if you have any suggestion of a resin that you would like me to test, please leave your comment down below and I will try to do my best to test it, okay? So without further ado, let's go to the resin review. So I found this resin on AliExpress. It's from a company called Resin, and since I really like to try new resins, I bought a bottle to test, and the main thing that caught my attention is that it's a high precision resin, so it should be perfect to print figurines and high detailed minis like the ones I have here, which is something that I do a lot. In my opinion, even more important than the 3D printer that you have is the resin that you use with it. If your resin is not good, no matter the screen resolution you have bad print. So that's why I have the right resin and dial in the settings is very, very important thing that you should always pay attention to, okay? The first aspect of this resin is the price. Now the price on their website is $35 plus $20 shipping for US, so $55. On AliExpress, it's $40 with free shipping for US buying directly from China. I don't know if they have other stories. I bought it from AliExpress, and since I live in Europe, they have a warehouse here in Spain, and they delivered it in 2 days. It was super good and fast delivery service, so I have no complaints on that. I was lucky enough to get a sale and bought it for 35 euros per liter, so you should keep an eye to see if you can get sales too. The price now for Europe is 45 euros per kilo, and I really believe it's a very good value for the money since it's a very good quality resin, okay? As you can see here, it comes very well packaged and with proper plastic bubble wrapping over it. Let me open here for you guys to see. It comes in a proper box and it comes like that with these plastic bubbles here around it protecting, and in a plastic bag to avoid any leakage or anything like that. So yeah, it's super well packaged, okay? Here I'm checking if the bottle they send it's really 1 kilogram, and it seems so. It has 100 more grams, but it's because of the bottle. But yeah, we have 1 kilogram of resin. This resin has a very thick consistency. It's more like melted chocolate instead of something more liquid, and different from other resins that I have here that are more liquid. And something that I really enjoy on this resin is the color. I like this salmon color. It really brings the details to life. So yeah, I really love it. I like the colors. One other interesting aspect of this resin is that you do not need to post-cure it once you remove it from the printer. It's ready to use just after you finish the print. I asked that information to the support and they confirmed that, and also said if you want, you can post-cure it for 1 minute to make it more harder and wear resistance. And for that particular feature, I can say this is really true. I did not post-cure any of these pieces here, and you can check that I can try to scratch it with my nails and nothing happens. What showed that the model is proper cured here, you see. I can try to scratch it as much as I can, and it's really cured. So it's really an interesting feature, in my opinion. Not super important, but something interesting for sure, since you do not need to worry about this extra step of post-cure your print. Another great aspect of this resin, it's how easy is the supports to come off. I don't know exactly why that happened, but it's really easy and even satisfying to remove the supports with this resin. I will show you here the process. I left this one here with supports just to show you how easy that is. It's basically with your bare hands, you can remove the supports without any big effort. It seems came off super easy. Let's see. This print is already cleaned. And that's it. You see? Super easy. It just came like butter. Super nice. Another thing is the smell. The smell is really low, almost no odor, to be honest. It does not bother me at all. It has less odor than other more famous brands that I have here, like Elegoo or everyone. I even can like bring close to my nose and do not feel like bad or any nausea or anything like that. Find the right settings for this resin was a little bit challenging. I think this is what people call slow resin, I think. If it do not cure well with less than 3 seconds, you need around 3 to 3.5 to cure it properly on a mono screen printer, okay? So I struggled a little bit before I figured out that, and I found a spreadsheet on their website with some recommended settings. I will link on the description for you guys to check, okay? Of course, this is a recommendation, a starting point. You need to go from there and find the right exposure for your printer, okay? You should pay attention to the bottom exposure time because it needs between 35 and 40 to work, and it's not recommended to have more than 4 bottom layers. This resin becomes very, very tough when you overexpose it. So it can be a pain to remove from the build plate and become very, very brittle if you expose for a long time to the UV light. For me, 40 seconds worked perfectly on my Photo Mono and on my Nova Benefor Mono. If I try less than that, I start to have problems with prints to not stick into the build plate. So make your tests to find the sweet spot for your printer, okay? One question that everyone asks is about the resistance of this resin. And the best way to show that is with some fall tests, right? And also I will put some force in some pieces that I've printed here to see how easily it can break. Also, I will compare it with Elegoo ABS-like and Elegoo Water Washable, which people normally say it's a brittle resin, so we can have some comparison to do. But have in mind, this is not the main feature of this resin, okay? This is a high precision resin, not a tough resin. So having that in mind, let's go to the test. This is the fall test. I started with the ABS-like from Elegoo. As you can see, it's more resistant. It survived for 2 falls without any damage to the model. The ME70, for the other hand, it break in the first fall, one arm, and in the second fall, it finished to break the other arm, but the model kept intact, even falling to the ground. The water washable just fell, break the first arm, and fell to the ground and finished to break there. This is the ABS-like. I tried to put some force here to break this piece, and it was considerably high force to break it. The ME70, surprisingly, took me a lot of effort to break. It bended more than break, and as you can see, I had to do a lot of effort to break it.
The water washable was the easiest one to break, so I just needed small effort to break it. So have in mind another thing, which is the time that you wash your prints on IPA. Be careful with that. You do not want to go over the recommended time, which is 2 minutes, because this resin tends to react with alcohol and generate some type of layer, white layer over the entire print, which is make it more difficult to clean later on, okay? It is recommended to brush the entire model after you clean it with alcohol, with a soft toothbrush, in order to avoid what I've talked before about this white layer that form over the print. So if you do that, it will be okay. And even if it creates a little bit of this white thing later, you can just scrub with the brush and remove it fine.
So in conclusion, what I can say about this resin, I like it. It's a good resin. It holds details amazingly. I really enjoy the result that it delivers. I don't know if I can recommend it as a, if you are going to use these pieces for tabletop, because as you saw on the tests, it is not super resistant. But if you want models for display, it's amazing for paint, for display. If you would like to have more details to paint and things like that, it's an amazing resin. So I totally recommend it. So that's it for today's video. I will leave you here with some very nice prints for you to check at the end of the video. If you enjoyed the content and want to see more resin reviews and other 3D print related content, please like and subscribe. And thank you very much for watching, and see you next time. Bye.